Next, coming to the differences between traditional data and big data. So these are the different characteristics between the traditional data and big data. Volume, the size is gigabytes or terabytes in the traditional system. Whereas big data, the size should be petabytes or zettabytes. So the size is increased in big data. So big data stores large amount of data when compared to traditional database systems. So next characteristics, organization maintains centralized data. So in big data, the organization maintains distributed data. Distributed data means the data is stored on two or more files or more servers. Structure, it follows the traditional data stores only structured data. Big data stores either structured data, semi-structured data or unstructured data. Structured data means in the form of tables or it follows some procedures. Okay, data models. So traditional data data model is schema based and big data is plot schema. What is schema? Schema is the structure of the database. So when we are storing the data on the database, it follows some structure and it follows some data types. So big data not follows any structure to storing the data on the database. So then it is called as a plot schema. Data relations. So traditional databases, data relations are complex, whereas big data, the data relations are simple relations. Okay. So next we are go to analytics. What is meant by analytics? Use of data, statistical analysis, exploratory and predictive models. So simply, the analysis or analytics means to retrieve the data from the database in the meaningful form from unstructured data using some procedures. So the data is in unstructured format. So we are using some procedures to retrieve that data into meaningful format, to transmit that data into meaningful format. That is called analysis. For example, a database consisting of employee data, employee names, salaries, employee designations, all these details are stored at one database. For example, I want the data from which employee have getting more than 50,000 salary. Which employee have getting more than 50,000 salary. So then what I am doing, simply I apply one query. So if salary equal to greater than or equal to 50,000, it retrieves all the data what I am asking. Okay, in the same thing, the data is unstructured, so not meaningful data. So whatever we are required data, that data is retrieved from the unstructured data. So into meaningful format using of some procedures. So that process is called as a analysis. That process is called as a analysis. Next, coming to the big data analytics. What is mean by big data analytics? So big data analytics is a process of collecting, organizing, analyzing, discovering data into useful information. So big data is the process of collecting, organizing, analyzing, discovering data into useful information. What is mean by collecting, organizing, analyzing, discovering and useful information? So consider a small example. For example, a university is conducting online exams in COVID-19 situations. So in that situation, definitely we are conducting the exam in online mode. So what type of precautions and what type of analysis first we are considered? So how many students have got laptops or smartphones? So how many students have internet facility? So first university collecting the data from all the related colleges, university related colleges. So that process is called as a collecting and organizing. So whatever university collecting the data is stored on one place, that is called as a organizing. So after organizing, they are analyzing. So what they are analyzing? So So how many students have laptops and how many students have internet facility? So how many did not have laptops? So they are applying some procedures. They are analyzing and discovering the data. So after analyzing and discovering the data, they get useful information. So this amount of people have laptop, this amount of people does not have laptops. So then the procedure will start based on that useful information. So this process is called as a big data analytics. So we are getting some useful information or valuable information. First we are collecting the data, organizing the data and perform analysis on particular data. Then we will get the useful information or value information. Okay. Next. How many types of analytics? Analytics are classified into four types. One is descriptive analysis, diagnostic analysis, predictive, prospective analysis. So descriptive analysis means what happened, why did it happen, what likely happened, what should I do about it. So this is the future analysis. What is likely happen, what should I do happen, this is the future analysis. So what happened, why did it happen is present analysis. So present or future analysis can be done using of analytics. So for example, consider an example. This is the BDA result, big data analytics results in last 5 years. So 2016 2017 18 19, 2016 consisting of 70% of result. In 2018, 60%, 70%, 80%, and 80% of result. So if the result is increased, why it is decreased in 2016? What happened in this? So in that situation, in that 2016, the new course is introduced, BDA. BDA is the new course in 2016. And in 2016, the regulation will be changed. Some R16 regulation to be introduced in this academic year. That way, this is new regulation and new subject. That way, the first percentage will be decreased in the 2016. So, in 2017, the percentage will be decreased. So, increased. Why it is increased? So, in previously, some knowledge on the BDA and also some related question papers and exam pattern is also based on that information. We increase the performance in 2017 and later. Okay, so in future we easily predict in future the result will be increases. The result will be increases because all our idea about what is big data. So in 2016 there is no idea for that regulation or for that course. In 2019 or 20 there is more idea on the big data, and it is not for the new regulation, it is old regulation. So there are some previous papers or previous pattern. Based on that knowledge, we are increasing the performance on the next year. Okay, these are the different applications which are used in big data. So these are the different various the big data application could be used: healthcare, manufacturing, e-commerce, media and entertainment, IoT, government, scientific and engineering. So in healthcare department, health records are stored, health data is stored using big data applications. So we can predict any disease data by using of big data applications. So in manufacturing department, we can estimate the cost of the product or manufacturing details. All these data should be predicted and managed by using of big data applications. So in e-commerce, so almost all